graph a polynomial function. Our goal, more specifically, is to be able to graph cubic functions with the aid of technology. A polynomial function is a function given in this form. Now, this may look complicated and involved, but in fact, it's not quite as bad as you might be thinking. N, or the exponents, are just any non-negative integer, and the a's with all of these subscripts are just the coefficients, and these must be real numbers. In general, creating graphs of polynomial functions other than linear and quadratic functions is difficult without a calculator. By hand, the best method is to make a t-table. Let's go ahead and take a look at some examples of polynomial functions that you're already familiar with. F of x equals negative 4, known as the constant function, and just for review, that is a polynomial function of degree 0. F of x equals 3x minus 8, of course, is a linear function. This is a polynomial function of degree 1. The next function, f of x equals x squared minus x minus 12, a quadratic function, also a polynomial function of degree 2. And then the last function, f of x equals negative x cubed plus x squared minus 3x plus 7, that's known as a cubic function of degree 3. Of course, we could make higher and higher degreed functions here that would all be polynomial functions. You kind of see the pattern. Let's go ahead and take a look at the graph of one of the most basic polynomial functions. And in fact, because it is a degree 3 polynomial function, this is your basic cubic function. Now, if we're not familiar with how to make this graph, it's always a good idea to go back to the t-table. So I'm going to go ahead and pick some x values, substitute these values into the function, and find the corresponding y value. I'll show a couple of these. The first value of x that we chose was negative 2. F of negative 2 is equal to negative 2 raised to the third power, which of course is negative 8. The rest of these you can probably do in our heads. If you cube negative 1, get negative 1. Cube 0, 0. If you cube 1, or raise 1 to the third power, you get a positive 1. If you raise positive 2 to the third power, you have a positive 8. Let's go ahead and plot these points and see what we have. If this is not enough points to see what the graph would look like, or if we're not sure, we need to pick some more points. Negative 2, negative 8. Negative 1, negative 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, and 2, 8. Now this graph does have a curve to it, and if we take a look at the graph with some technology, we will see that it looks like this. So many polynomial functions have curves in them. Let's go ahead and take a look at another cubic function that's a little more involved. H of x equals x cubed minus 4x. Well, by just adding this one extra term, it is going to affect the graph dramatically. Let's go ahead and hit y equals, type in our function, x raised to the third power minus 4x. Let's go ahead and hit graph. Now, as you can see, just that one term of minus 4x affected this graph considerably and now has two turns in it, and it has a much different shape. So obviously to graph this by hand would take a lot more work, but with aid of technology we can graph this fairly accurately and fairly quickly. If I was to try to graph this on a piece of paper, I would hit second graph and pick several of these points that would be easy to plot and then do the best that I could by hand. Let's explore the graphs of cubics or degree 3 polynomials. I have a link here to the exploration. This current graph is the basic function that we just graphed ourselves, f of x equals x cubed. However, there are some sliders down here at the bottom that will allow you to change the values of a, b, c, and d. And when you change the values of a, b, and c, you will be allowed to see how it affects the graph. For example, if I change the value of a, you can see it does affect how the graph behaves going to the left and going to the right. If I change the value of d, you can see that it affects the y-intercept. And the values of B and C seem to affect how the graph behaves or how many turns it has. So it's fairly involved, but you can see that it does have an effect on the graph. If you'd like to, you can go ahead and play around with this. It gives you a general idea of how these values would affect the graph. I'll leave you with a thought.